If you're shopping for a new processor, it is time for you to say goodbye to your X. Let us show you what's next. I'm gonna spill the tea in XT and check out AMD's newest 3000XT processors. Are these processors more extreme? Or are they just extra? Like pointless, in case you're not Malaysian and didn't catch that. Moving on! When Intel released their 10th Gen Comet Lake processors, we know that AMD showed something and they have something to say. They released three new processors, the 3600XT, the 3800XT, and the 3900XT. But we only have the 3600XT and the 3800XT in the lab today. Why? Because I'm not Linus, lor. And I also want to ask. Anyways, AMD said that these new 3000XT processors are actually a result of optimizing their existing 7nm process to improve single-threaded performance. No doubt thanks to their experience while making the brand new 3rd-gen Threadripper CPUs. Also, if your motherboard already supports the existing 3000 series lineup, you won't need to update your BIOS. That's a plus for AMD, as in A+. But you know what? Since these processors are not meant to be replacements for the existing 3000X processors, it's going to be very confusing for you guys, since you're probably not as smart as me. I'm gonna take a look at specs, do some benchmarks, and check out its overclocking capabilities to help you make a more informed purchase decision. You're welcome. When it comes to specs, the 3600XT is pretty much the same as the standard 3600X, except for an extra 100MHz in the max boost clock. Both of these processors will ship with the Rave Spire cooler. The 3800XT, on the other hand, has a 200MHz higher boost clock than the regular 3800X. Also, the regular 3800X comes with a Rave Prism cooler with RGB lighting, but the 3800XT does not. AMD is making the assumption that consumers are probably gonna be using aftermarket coolers, but it's still good to have options, isn't it? Here are the parts that we're using for our test bench. For the CPU cooler, we're using the Thermotech Water 3.0 360 ARGB Sync AIO. For the motherboard, we're using the ASRock X570 Tai Chi. For memory, we're using 4 sticks of Jill Super Loose AMD Edition, rated at 3000MHz, but we're overclocking it to 3200MHz. For the graphics card, we're using the ASUS ROG Strix RTX 2070 Super. For storage, 2TB of Gigabyte Aorus NVMe M.2 Gen 4 SSD. And finally, for the power supply, we're using the Cooler Master V750 750W 80+ Gold fully modular power supply. Moving on to benchmarks, we don't really have a 3600X, so we compared these processors to our 3700X and 3900X. Looking at synthetic benchmarks, it seems that the single-threaded performance out of these new XT processors are a little bit higher in some cases, especially in Cinebench R20 and RealBench. In gaming benchmarks, we're seeing quite a bit of improvement in higher resolutions for Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and the difference is even more noticeable in older titles like Shadow of War. We also tested Death Stranding with these new processors to see how much the performance scales when it comes to higher core counts. We're surprised to see that the 3600XT keep up pretty well in 4K, but still loses out to the 3800XT in 1080p and 1440p. In real-world benchmarks, we tested the new processors in multi-threaded tasks that we do a lot in the office, namely After Effects and Premiere Pro. As expected, the 3600XT is slower than the 3700X, followed by the 3800XT, with the 3900X on top. And those are the numbers. Now before we conclude this video, let's check out the overclocking capabilities of these new 3000XT processors, since they are supposed to have a better silicon quality. Full disclaimer, for everyday use, we recommend that you go for a dynamic overclock and not a static overclock. Or you could just stick to stock settings to be on the safe side, because there's nothing wrong with a little bit more protection when you play. Play safe, guys. Also, you could check out the auto overclocking feature in the Ryzen Master software, again, at your own risk, but you should definitely get a beefier liquid cooler to keep temperatures in check and give you a little bit more headroom in overclocking. As you can see with the 3600XT, we managed to get to a 4.6GHz all-core overclock at a pretty reasonable voltage. Now with the 3800XT, again, we managed to
to get to a pretty reasonable 4.4 GHz all core at also a very reasonable voltage. I do not recommend that you set your voltage too high because we've seen numerous reports of chip degradation at high 1.3 to 1.4 volts in static overclocks.
Time for the conclusion. Now, should you run out and buy these new 3000 XT processors? When they were first released, they were priced at the same retail price as their corresponding older 3000X processors. We're a bit late to the party. Now the 3600 XT and the 3800 XT are both about 1 to 200 ringgit more expensive than the existing lineup. Links in the description below that you should click on because I'm nicer to you than your girlfriend. She every day asks you don't buy. Every day I say to you, cheap buy. If you're already a proud owner of the existing 3000X processors, you should probably skip this upgrade because you won't notice much of a performance bump. With the 3600XT, like the older 3600X, it is actually a very well-positioned product, the perfect balance between work and play. But the 3800XT is actually kind of weird. It is more expensive than the 3700X, and I feel that if you're already looking at this price point, you should probably spend a couple more $100. Tambah lagi for the 3900X because it has 4 more cores. With 12 cores and 24 threads, it is actually very threadening for all your multi-threaded productivity tasks. If you're building a pure gaming PC, you should probably check out the Ryzen 3 3300X. While we didn't do a full review on that processor, while we were testing it out, we managed to find similar numbers to those that were presented to us by reputable sources like Gamer Nexus as well as Linus Tech Tips that showed that it performed almost on par with the Ryzen 5 3600X in certain titles. That's all, folks. If you thought this video is awesome, don't forget to give it a like and share. And also leave a comment down below, let us know if you would buy a 3000 XT processor and why. And if you won't, why? Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to see more uploads from us. And follow us on Facebook so that you can join our weekly live stream and talk to us a little bit more. Since I know you don't have people to talk to anyways. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Just kidding, nah. I know you got a lot of friends. Don't need to brag to me.